I'm Rob Wootton, and this fine specimen of a man is Lee Kerry. We're both match anglers. We fish big competitions all over Europe, representing our country. We love competition fishing, but quite often we have to sacrifice quality fish for a net of the safer option, those smaller species.
We want to change that, and this series is all about targeting one of those big specimen fish that so often avoid us. Fish of this size are super crafty, and we hope to use our match fishing tactics to fool one of these giants.
So, we've just arrived on the river, the lovely, lovely River Trent. But before we can even talk about doing anything, me and Rob are going to fish on the same peg today with two rods, Rob.
It's a scaled down specimen approach, isn't it? We're going to have a lovely friendly day.
It's going to be a great day, but because it's so friendly and because there's only two rods, if there's only one bite, before we even get the rods out, we need to decide who's going to have the first fish. Now, I feel for this video, a coin toss is the one. So if you toss it,
hang on. Right? I just want you to check that there's tails on that side and a head's on that side.
Of hand. I've seen your sleight of hand.
Okay.
Okay. You toss, you toss.
Are you going to shout?
I know what I'm shouting. I'm shouting. Yeah, go.
We'll see if we can find it in this grass.
There you go. Heads.
Oh, it's disappeared. So obviously Lee's going to get first fish. Then we'll take it in turns from there. We're both going to work super hard though in baiting up. We're both going to work together. And you know what? We're match anglers, so there's a competitive element, but I think Lee's going to be just as happy if I catch my PB as I am when he catches his PB. We're both going to help each other out today. It's going to be a mega day. The wind is horrendous, so that might make things difficult, but you know, let's see if we catch a fish. What a beautiful but windy day to be out on the bank today. We're on the mighty River Trent. Tell the folks at home the target for today.
The plan. Well, the plan is today, Rob and I don't get a chance for these big fish very often, but we've come to the River Trent because we know it's full of barbel and big ones at that. I'm saying, Rob, any double figure barbel's a massive fish.
It's huge.
When we go match fishing, we get a limited amount of time on the bank, don't we? So we don't always want to, like, say, spend our 5 hours fishing for one fish when we feel we can catch more smaller fish. So the plan is today to attack the River Trent match style, but for a double figure barbel.
As you can see, we've not picked an easy day. It's absolutely blowing a gale today. I mean, we've got a nice little den here. We've got the brolly set up. We've got a really nice comfy setup. This is a little bit removed from our match fishing situation, isn't it? Where we've got a box and we're sometimes huddled down on that seat box, tea for the wind, and we can't make ourselves comfortable.
I love a good den, Rob. I love a good den. And we've got a good den today. I've even managed to get myself a little bit of a bed on the bank so I can mix between my den and the bed. But yeah, look, I think the way we're going to fish, because it's a little bit slower than how we usually do it, we need somewhere a little bit comfortable, but I want to be up and down. I want to be active. You know, I want to be up and down today.
You talk about being slower and keeping everything, you know, a little bit more laid back in comparison to our match fishing. I don't want to take it too far because I'm sure that if we can use our busy style of fishing, our active match fishing style, you know what it's like. You hook some of these massive fish in a match fishing situation. And I think if we keep that up, even today, I'm sure we're going to hook some big fish.
Absolutely. I'm thinking as well. I love lots of fish as well. I'd be happy if maybe a little bit of a numbers game to try and stack that bigger fish in my favour, you know what I mean? I'd be happy if we get a few bites today, working in and out. Although the big one is the goal, conditions are good, aren't they?
Spot
I'm no specialty angler, but this is like blustery, windy.
When the wind's in the west, the fish bite the best.
Nice. I think we're going to get something.
Yeah, that was
arced
over that one.
And that was
but I bet it did drop back when we weren't looking.
Yeah, maybe.
Who's worried, Rob, on the old barbel about the late surge?
You know, when you get them there, and they come up and you think, I've got him. You think, I've got him. And then he goes, and then there's another 50 yard run.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
What I'm saying, I'm going to get the net ready.
Feels like a feisty 4 or 5 pound fish.
It's not plodding, is it, like a big double figure fish?
But they're fast and they've got big tails. And if you're not careful, they're the ones that break you against the feeder, aren't they?
Come on, come on. Yeah. Listen, mate, that's a cracking fish. What a fantastic start. I think we'll just leave him in the net for a second. And we'll have a look at him because he's immaculate, you know.
Let me tell you, mate, that, what a start that is.
What
that
a great start.
That's a great start. Just over 7 pound. I mean, that's a beautiful fish. Anyway, look, I love a barb. Look how powerful and it's immaculate, that fish is.
Immaculate fish. They're in immaculate condition. Complete and utter pure muscle when you're dealing with a barbel. A 7 pounder, fight of its life, isn't it? I want to slip in back, Rob. We're in search of that double. Come on, let's get
it's
in.
My turn now.
Yeah, I don't believe it. Right, I'm releasing the barbel back. Had plenty of time to recover. Always like to make sure a barbel fit and ready. Look, it's fighting against me. And away she goes. That's what I want. I want the fish to be nice and fit. I've got a cheer rob on for the next one, but what a fantastic start.
Today's session, we're using our standard feeder gear. Now, there's a tiny bit of extra water on the river today. So although I'd love to use a really soft rod, a 12 foot rod, I think something slightly beefed up is going to be the way to go. So we've got a 13 foot rod there. This is the sort of rod that I'd use for bream and skimmers on a lake. So it doesn't need to be overly heavy. And on this rod, we've got a main line of 10 pound. We don't want to lose any fish today. There's a lot of snags in this river. We want to be able to bully a fish away from a snag if needed. 10 pound line, it's as tough as old boots. We're not going to get broke on that. Right, down to the business end. We've got a really long hook length. This is nearly 6 foot in length, this hook length. There's good reason for that. These fish have been caught loads of times before. They're super wary. They know what main line is. They know what a feeder is. And quite often those cagey big fish will sit away from all of that disturbance. And what we need to do is keep our hook bait away from that feeder. So a hook length that's nearly 6 feet in length. This is 8 pound line. We've got a size 12 hook on, not a huge hook, nice small hook. On that hook, we can put 4, 5, 6 maggots. Think a bait presented on that gear is going to be the route to success.
Best thing about pleasure fishing, trip to the calf. So sorted everybody out, even the cameraman. Happy days. My bacon and sausage.
B&S, bacon and sausage. Bacon and egg for me. Bacon and sausage for the cameraman, that's important. Look at this.
Yeah,
homemade
Jack
brownie.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, and some nice big sausage roll for later. And because you don't like any sort of caffeine, you've got a hot chocolate. There's also some sauce as well.
Stunning array.
Yeah, looks like a perfect time to have a little break, doesn't it?
Well, I'll tell you what I've had. I've had one date and one person
you've been
on.
Have you?
I've baited up for you.
Oh, well done, mate. Set it up. Set it up. They know I'm back now, don't they?
Put some more hemp and pellets in. And I think, what was it? It's about 10 minutes after we've put the bait in, isn't it, usually? We'll be getting a bite.
10 to 15 minutes.
So would you abide, and I reckon you'll be putting your challenge down for taking.
Just be...
Oh. Bubble.
These are... These are... Big flat skin, a bit tighter.
Get this rod, mate. Get this rod. When they go, it's beautiful, isn't it?
When you're on balanced tackle, how much enjoyment you get out of the battle. Even the sun's coming out for it, Bob. It's brilliant.
I mean, you can still, if I needed to, I think I could bully this fish away from any snags. Why risk that? I don't think there's any snags in the swim. I don't think I need to bully this fish. I just need to sort of like hold it and...
You would have potential. If you've got a big tree here, if it darted for it, you might have to be a little bit more forceful. But I think a lot of fish get lost like that, you know?
Yeah, they do,
I'd rather a fish actually snag me than pull out of it, bullying it, you know? I don't like that. I'm not, I I'll tell you what, that's a bit slower than mine.
This is a plodder, mate. This is a plodder. I'm hoping this is a big, heavy plodder.
Yeah. And I'll tell you what, this looks like a nice fish.
Oh. He's a bit chunkier, isn't he?
Yeah, I couldn't get my hands around him. He might be nine. I'll do the way. The other person does the way. Ready?
Eight and a half, yeah. Listen, I'll take 8.5 any day.
8.5, yeah.
Any day. What a beautiful fish. Look how nice they are. They're just
immaculate.
Go.
What a beautiful fish. He was on 6 or 7 maggots, so that's 2 for the maggot. I'm absolutely buzzing with that. 8.5 pound as well. Well done, mate.
Superb.
Bigger than mine, but I'm not jealous
anyway. Listen, your turn next. I reckon they're getting bigger.
Absolutely brilliant. Right, we're going to let him recover, get him back. Beautiful fish.
The easiest of baits for our session today, Bob and I love to fish with these sort of baits when we're fishing usual matches, and it really is straightforward. So first of all, got some good old fashioned maggots, reds and whites mixed. We always love to mix it up a bit with colour. Don't really think it matters, to be fair, but everyone's got a preference, but plenty of them with us today. If you're coming all day, you're gonna want 2 or 3 pints at least. And then this is the key bait for me. This is hemp. Now, specimen anglers love to feed it, but match anglers love to feed it as well. And you're going to need a load. If you're here all day, you're going to want to bring plenty of hemp, lots of bait with you. It's a lovely bait to put through your feeder. But we also know that on these sort of venues that the barbel love halibut pellets. They love pellets. They want to eat them. But I think a lot of people got obsessed with piling loads of them in and big ones at that. So as match anglers, we love a small halibut pellet. These are some 4 mils here, look. And all we're going to do is add a couple of handfuls every time we put the hemp into the tub, mix it around. So basically our hemp is a mixture of halibuts and hemp, but hardly any pellets. Don't want loads. Don't want the fish preoccupied on that. I want them eating hemp and maggots. Dead simple, so I can put maggots on the hook. If we have a problem with getting bitted out, we're just going to put small pellets on the hook, like 6 mil pellets or even possibly an 8 mil. We're not going to fish those big, heavy pellets that a lot of people fish. These fish are way too cute for that. They get fished way too often. So we believe that sort of style should work really well. Dead easy, simple array of baits there.
I feel barbly. I feel very barbly. It's a barbly time.
Big fish, do you think?
See that one jump?
The one just jumped?
Something just jumped.
Summertime they jump, don't they? But
brilliant. Doesn't feel as big as Rob, but teamwork equals dream work, as they say. But you never know, if she comes, she's on the bomb rig. There's the one left in, we haven't even chucked the feeder back out.
I refuse to call it the bomb rig. I can call it a straight lead because it is lead, but I'm not going to call it a bomb rig because it's not a bomb. Yeah, I know. I always feel, you know, barbel are so powerful that even if we had really strong line on that run, you're still going to get broken. You need to be able to let these fish go, don't you?
I remember once fishing with some really heavy specimen tackle. And I thought, well, I'll just be able to bully him in with this rope. And I just couldn't do it. You know, I think I'm way too cavalier and losing odd.
A double figure barbel is a specimen. That's a specimen fish, isn't it? You want me ready? With my scooping. Ooh! Yeah, I'm saying he's a double figure fish. No, I'm saying he's easy double.
What we got, Rob?
Hang on, hold your horses. 11. I'm giving
11,
you
he's 11.
11 pound.
Yeah, he's 11. He was
on the nose.
11 one, but yeah, 11 pound.
11 pound on the nose. Get him out. Show everyone.
Yeah. Great fish. Not quite as fat. He's a long one. That's for sure. Look at that.
Absolutely super. And you know what? Every single fish has been in mint condition. Beautiful condition. And haven't they four?
Brilliant.
Don't barbel give you a proper scrap.
They give you the fight of their lives. Amazing fishing, amazing.
We keep saying it, but that has been an amazing day. I've loved every second of it.
Tell you what, mate. Sun setting. The sky is a little bit blue. One of my best mates in the world is playing a barbel next to me.
This is the stuff dreams are made of, isn't it?
What a great day.
Absolutely fantastic day. I mean, look at this. It's been a beautiful day, you know. The wind's dropped, the sun's out.
Brilliant, mate. Absolutely brilliant. I'll tell you what I'm hoping. I mean, we didn't know what size of fish we were going to catch today, but they've all been in that 6 to 8.5 pound bracket. We've had lots of runs, we've had loads of action. And if this is the last fish of the day, whether it's £5 or £15, I'm delighted.
I'm going to say, this feels like a decent fish, you know, Leo. It feels like a decent fish. Now, every barbel we've caught has felt a big fish, hasn't it? But again, I keep going back to it. We're using balanced tackle.
Sun's out now, it's just glorious. I can see why people love doing this style of fishing so much. Looks like it's giving you a little bit of a run around this fish.
I'm quietly confident. Oh, yeah. This is a nice fish. I'm quietly confident. It's staying low,
yeah.
But it's nodding and.
The profile of these fish do that, don't they? Like,
they do.
Obviously, when we've shown them earlier, the head's down, like rocking along the bottom. They almost like to get them up off the bottom is a mission in itself, isn't it? So, you know, it's not let us down, has it? That tackle we had that little incident earlier, which obviously. Funny when the fish came off, you could hammer me as I played the next several.
I will say, you know when you sat there for the next half an hour after losing those two fish comfort eating in the brolly? It didn't look like you found it that funny.
Yeah, right now I've netted another few. I'll put on that one.
Right. Go on. Ready? I think he's got to be £10.
Really?
Oh, hang on.
What is he?
I'm going to say he's 11.
Yes, well done, mate.
14.
Brilliant. Nearly was a double.
Wow. You know what?
I'm so happy.
You know what? Last knockings of the day. Sun just setting.
Yeah, it's an hour a day.
It's barbel o'clock, isn't it? Barbel o'clock.
We felt it, didn't we? Felt there was a chance of that bigger fish. I mean, these sort of fish, you can see how broad they are across the back. I mean,
I'm over the moon with that, you know.
Shot, mate. But listen, he is an absolute powerhouse across the back. What a brilliant day's fishing. Hold him up for the guys. You can see how big and muscly they are and strong, which is why this is such
exciting
fish. I'll tell you,
Lee, that is a pellet eater. That is like you. Look at the belly on it.
Hey, it wasn't a pellet eater today, it was a maggot eater.
A maggot eater, yeah.
That's exactly what we needed. The big fins, look at the size of the fins. You know, when they're coming out of the water, no wonder they're so powerful. Pure muscle, huge fins. That is a day's fishing, mate.
What a day.
Absolutely brilliant.
We've had a fantastic day today. Lee and I have been on the River Trent. Massive thanks to Knots Piscatorials. We've been on a fantastic stretch of water. We've caught loads of barbel today, topped off by this beauty. fantastic day's fishing, fantastic company as well. What a day. Cracking fish to end the session on. Final goodbyes to a beautiful Trent Barbel. I can't wait for our next quest for a PB.